In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone. Today we celebrate the 21st Sunday of Ordinary Time. We thank you for being with us and for finding us through the internet in whatever way that you do find us. It's always a joy to have you with us and to celebrate our faith, to celebrate this Mass together with you. As we prepare now to encounter Christ in this Eucharist on this Sunday, the Day of the Lord, let us acknowledge the fact that we are sinful people, that we need God's mercy and forgiveness in our lives. Let us ask Him now to grant us pardon and mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give over to him your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God! How inscrutable are his judgments and how unsearchable his ways! For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor, or who has given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked the disciples, "Who do the people say that the Son of Man is?" And they replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." And Jesus said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" And Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of John, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loosed on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus asks a very pointed question of the disciples today that is a question that can be asked for each one of us in our faith. Who do you say that I am? And that's important for each one of us as Christian people. Who do we say Jesus is? Is he, for us, the Messiah? Is he the Christ? Is he the Son of God, the Messiah that God sent into this world to save us? And each one of us, as Christians, we need to acknowledge that and answer that question, just as Jesus pointed that to his disciples. So they said, some of them said, well, you are Jeremiah, you're Elijah, you're John the Baptist, or one of the prophets, or whatever. But Jesus points to them and says, who do you say that I am? And just as that question is poised to them, it's poised to us as well. St. Peter, whom Jesus appointed as the head of the apostles, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, said, you are the Christ. You are the Son of the living God. And Jesus responds by saying, Peter, or Simon, son of Jonah, you have said this, not on your own, but because God has revealed this. My Father has revealed this to you, that you have made that proclamation. Because for Peter, that was an extraordinary thing, a very powerful thing that he said. Because as a Jew, the Jews believe that God is one. And to say that Jesus is the Son of God was blasphemy, really, for him. And so it required a lot of strength and courage for Peter to say what he did in acknowledging Jesus as the Son of the living God. But he did so because he knew that it was true. And that proclamation of faith was for all of us to hear and to accept that Jesus truly is the Messiah, and even more so, that he is the Son of God, that Jesus himself is God, the incarnate Word of God. And so Jesus, in response to that, said, and so I say to you that you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. Now we have to remember that the name Peter means the rock. And so if we did a literal translation of that scripture, Jesus would have said, and you are rock, or maybe perhaps you are rocky, and upon this rock I will build my church. Because on Peter's faith, upon that person of Peter, who is the rock, who gave that proclamation of faith, Jesus indeed built his church. And he gave Peter the keys to the kingdom of heaven, just as we heard in the first reading in the book of the prophet Isaiah, that Eliakim was given the keys. So Peter was given the keys as the one who stands at the gates of heaven. We often see the image of Peter with that, with the keys to the kingdom of heaven. That was because Jesus gave him that authority to be the one to stand there at the gates, to open those gates to all of us who profess our faith in Jesus, just as Peter did, to let them into the kingdom of heaven. Jesus also made him as the head of the church. And he said to him, whatever you declare bound on earth is bound in heaven. He made Peter the ambassador of the kingdom to allow us, according to his word, to know what is right and what is wrong, what is good, what is accepted, what is rejected. Peter had that capacity in the light of the Spirit to know that and to guide the church in its journey toward Jesus. And so we who are part of the church, that we are in this community of the church, that we are guided by the church in all that we do, all that we believe. And today, that succession has been handed down through the generations of time, all the way to our Holy Father today, who is Pope Francis. And that's an incredible legacy, an incredible succession of authority. Jesus just didn't leave his church to be left to Peter, and then after he would die, that it would, you know, just be floundering about. But he meant for that to keep on going through the generations of time. And all those over 200 popes later, Pope Francis today is the one that is in that chair of St. Peter, that he is the one who is leading us and guiding us in the way of our faith. And so we accept that as he being the true successor of St. Peter. Now Jesus, at the end, he's told his disciples, don't tell anybody he was the Christ, because Jesus wanted all of the people, even us, to come to that to accepting him as the Christ, as the Messiah, through faith. He wanted us to be able to make that decision on our own, to weigh the evidence, to see what we see, and then to come to that crucial point in our lives that, yes, we believe that Jesus is the Messiah, for he truly is. And it is the entire church that has lasted these 2,000 years that has proclaimed Jesus as the Messiah, and we believe that. Even today, in this world that is so mixed up and so uncentered as it is, we, through the church, are carried in our faith to hold Jesus as the Son of God, as the Messiah, as the Savior of the world that the Father has sent to us to lead us into his kingdom. And that kingdom is a glorious and great place. That Jesus, who has told us when he was himself dying on the cross, he told to the repentant thief, today you will be with me in paradise. And that kingdom of paradise is promised to all of us, to you and me. We are to be a part of that kingdom, to live the fullness of life forever. And that is God's gift to all of us. And it is by the grace of God that we accept that gift. And in conclusion, I'd like just to tell you the short little story. There were these two Christian people who lived very good lives, and they lived healthy lives. And the two of them die, and they both go to heaven. And so as they're walking along, they're marveling at the paradise that's around them. They're looking at heaven and how wonderful it is. And one turns to the other and says, Wow, I never knew that heaven was going to be as beautiful as this is. And the other one says to him, yeah, and just think, if we hadn't eaten all that oat bran during our lives, we could have gotten here 10 years sooner and enjoyed all of this. Heaven is our goal and the place that we are all headed. So let us be grateful to God for that gift that he gives to us, and the reassurance that through his grace, heaven is ours. And now join with me as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord's love is eternal. So we have the confidence to bring our needs and the needs of all our brothers and sisters now before God.
For Pope Francis, that he may be guided by the Holy Spirit as he leads us closer to truly realizing the mission of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected leaders, that they may be guided by empathy for the people they serve and consider the effects of their decisions that they make on the least of them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students, teachers, and administrators, at the beginning of a new school year, that they return to the classroom eager to discover new things, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from illnesses and for their caregivers and loved ones, that they may be given courage and hope to endure the crosses they bear, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us, that by the way we serve those who are in need, we may reveal who the Lord is to our community and our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the names and intentions listed in our parish community book of prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they be welcomed into eternal life, which God gives through his Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the Velarde family for whom this Mass is offered, and for our own private intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. O God, your kindness endures forever. Look with kindness on us here today and hear the prayers that we make. Grant them according to your holy will, for we make them in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Lead on, O weary one.
Please pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name on all of his holy church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We'll lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Father, laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever to praise you in your mighty works through Jesus Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, Father, as in joyful celebration we now acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become the body and blood of your Son and our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night that he was betrayed, Jesus himself took bread, and giving you thanks, Father, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and giving you thanks, Father, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and his ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George Leo Thomas, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family that you have gathered here now before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now, at our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, Lord, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other now a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called now to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone, as always, for joining us and being with us as we celebrate this Mass on this 21st Sunday of Ordinary Time in the Church's liturgical year. I thank all of you for being with us and finding us through social media, however you have reached us. Thank you for being with us. And we're glad that we are able to pray with you and praise God today together. And like I always say, even though you might be alone, you are with us. And Jesus said, wherever two or more are gathered together in his name, he is with us. And so know that Jesus is truly with you, to lift you up in spirit and to be with you, to bless you and grant you his grace always. I thank all of those who assisted at Mass today, very few of us, but thank you to Julia for being our lector today, and Michael for helping us with the cameras and keeping us here so you can see us. And to our beautiful music, David and Eva, thank you so much for lifting us up in spirit with your music and all that. We are truly grateful to be able to celebrate this Mass, and we thank you for your support and your contributions that you get to us through our online giving, through mailing in your support, through coming to the office or calling online to our office. Thank you so much for supporting us and helping us continue on in our mission, especially during this very challenging time of this COVID virus. If you are having a birthday celebration or an anniversary or something special that's going on in your life this day or this week, we celebrate with you because we need all the joy that we can now. And we also want you to know that our prayers are with you. If you are experiencing some challenging things, heavy things that are going on in your life, heavy on your soul, please know that our prayers are with you, that Jesus may lift you with his grace and his spirit. And so until the next time that we meet together for the celebration of the Mass, please go with the Lord's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is now ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord always by your life.
Thanks be to God.